Hey guys, welcome back to Everyday South Texan. So today we're going to be adding a zigzag cleat for the anchor on the kayak, and we're going to paint it. We're going to prep it. We're going to clean it with some isopropyl alcohol. We're just going to wipe it down. I've got some acetone, but I don't want to use that. I feel like that's going to be too harsh on the plastics. And so we're just going to remove all this stuff here, the cover, the top, the screws for the strap here on the top. Everything that can be removed, we're gonna take it off, and we're not gonna remove any of this or this. We're gonna cut this out of here. I got some new shock cord for the kayak, and we're gonna use some neon green, and we're gonna paint it with some Plastidip blaze orange. So stick around and check it out. Alright guys, here we go. I've got the blaze orange Plastidip. I've got it masked off from waterline pretty much. This is like soup. This is the smooth portion of it. This is a little bit textured. I went ahead and masked off all of the holes where the screws went. Pulled the drain plug here. Took the storage compartment cover off. I'm not too worried about this getting paint on it. I'm not really going to spray this area because it's covered. This area is covered 100% of the time by the storage compartment cover. So, yeah. Alright guys, so that's one can, gave it a light coat pretty much all the way around. And so some of the videos I've watched, you really don't find them about Plastidipping your kayak. A lot of them are Plastidipping rims and your car and things like that, but I wanted to do my kayak. Reason why I chose bright orange, you can see I had a couple boo-boos, a little heavy on in some spots, no big deal. The reason I chose the bright orange was in case I'm in the intercoastal waterway, maybe a little bit more visible. I was going to go the neon green, the blaze green, but the water's green where I am, so I didn't want to blend in. My life jacket is brown, and so I'm hoping this will help me stick out so I don't get run over by boats and things like that, because where I go, boats can light it up and really take off. So that's one coat. And it says let it sit for 30 minutes before doing another coat. So we're going to do that, and I'll come back later. Guys, here we are. Second coat. See what turns out. Alright folks, that's two coats. You can see I didn't get everything 100% covered. We still got some yellow popping through. But for the majority, most of it is covered in two coats. And it's starting to cover up some of that black staining. You see here, some of that black is still popping through. So I did clean this thing with Purple Power. And I believe it was diluted to 5-to-1 ratio. And then I cleaned it with isopropanol alcohol. So any of the black that's coming through is just staining. I couldn't get it out of the plastics. I washed it first with Dawn dish soap. Then I let it dry. Then I tried to get as much of the dirt and grime off as I could. And that's what I could get out. But so far, this is what it's looking like. And so yeah, that's two coats in. And we'll see what a third coat does to it. And it's starting to look a lot better, a lot darker, a lot oranger. So I like it. Stick around. Okay guys, I just finished the third coat and third can. So one can will paint the whole thing with a light coat all the way around. So this is my third can. I've got one more can left. I'm going to wait till I've got a little sunlight tomorrow. I am waiting 30 minutes between each coat. So this fourth coat, we'll have a lot more than 30 minutes.
I wanted to get a good even coat for the whole thing. I may buy some more cans. I had to buy it online. Couldn't find any of the stores locally. So I may either buy some more online and then finish painting it, or just paint it with the last can and see what I got and then leave it as is. So this is what three coats, also three cans, will do. I believe my kayak's just around 13 feet long. So it's an Ocean Kayak Drifter. It's a lot older kayak, but I think this is gonna help the longevity of the UV rays beating up on it and stuff like that. So we'll see what it looks like here in the sun. So yeah, hang in there. All right, folks, check it out. Got my full four coats on of Plastidip Blaze Orange. Came out pretty good. I did have some tear out when I was removing the masking tape. You can see here, 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 and wherever I put the masking tape, I had to wait 2 days before I could finish the last coat. The day that I was doing it, the humidity rolled in and it just got super humid, so I packed it up and put it in the garage, and the next couple days the humidity cleared out and air dried. So you can see I've got a couple where the masking tape was. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a razor blade. Anything that's loose or hanging like that, I'm just going to give it a little cut. Nope, hardly doesn't take any pressure at all, but using a razor blade. I already did it here because I had a pretty big little flap that I jacked up when I peeled the tape off. So I'm going to do the rest of that here. Just show you guys. That's all it takes, just light, and literally no pressure at all. Just gonna go right above where it didn't adhere or I had the tear out because of the tape. And I'm gonna go and clean it all up, and then I'm gonna put all the hardware back on. I did end up buying some new pad eyes. I said, you know what, might as well. I got a 20 pack, I think it was like $6. Came with a bunch of stainless steel self-tappers. I don't need these. But if I wanted to just tap into someplace else and add some more pad eyes, where maybe adding an anchor trolley, I'll do that later. But I don't need the screws now. I just needed the pad eyes, and they came with it. So having an extra hardware doesn't hurt. So I'm going to put all new pad eyes everywhere so that all my hardware will be nice and fresh. And yeah. So I'm going to trim all this up, install the hardware, and show y'all what it looks like when she's put together. Alright folks, check it out. Here's the finished product of Plastidip, and I put new paracord for the handles. Ended up installing an anchor trolley here with the zigzag cleat. Reinstalled all the hardware. Got everything set up. This is what it'll look like. Come on the side. Got an anchor trolley on this side. Got the neon green shock cord. Unfortunately, the tank well is too small to fit a milk crate, so I'll probably just put my, I've got a soft cooler that I'll take with me, and that'll just go here, and then whatever other gear I need to take. I've got a collapsible anchor in there, and then I've got my seat set up. So that's how it turned out. I like the way the color came out. It's pretty bright, pops, and yeah, so that's been Everyday South Texan. Thanks for joining me on my journey for plastidipping my kayak. And yeah, later.